now our final contestant before our break. Finalist number 8, Sable Chanel. Sable, 3 minutes to say whatever you would like to say.
Hello. I am your contestant number 8, Sable Chanel. Tonight I represent the Miss Gay South Carolina USA pageant. Tonight we are here, all here to celebrate the art of female impersonation. So that is the topic I would like to talk about tonight. Is female impersonation really an art form? So let me refer, first of all, to a definition of art by Webster's New World Dictionary. Definition number 1, human creativity. Well, I don't know about each one of you all, but it took a lot of human creativity to bring forth the illusion that you see standing on this stage tonight. And I'm sure each and every one of you that participate in this will say the same. Definition number 2, any specific skill or its application. Skill is something I don't think that one is born with. I think it's something that is a never-ending process. And I believe that anyone that works in this field can say that skill is what it's all about. Skill is used in applying one's makeup, stage performance, costuming, and essence. Definition number 3, any craft or its principles. I do believe female impersonation is definitely a craft. It's a craft that's been around for thousands of years. It began years ago, thousands of years ago, in the kabuki theater, Japanese kabuki theater, where women were not allowed to appear on the stage, so men had to dress in female attire to take their place. So going back that long ago, it might be safe to say that female impersonation might be the second oldest profession. Number 4, making things that have form or beauty. If any one of you all has been an observer of the USA finals all week long or just being here tonight, I'm sure that doesn't need any further explanation because you will know that there have been many forms of beauty that have walked across the stages this week and tonight. And last but not least, cunning, sly tricks. Female impersonation to me is also the art of deception. It is deceiving the spectator sitting out in the audience into believing that what he is seeing on stage is real. So it is safe to say in my eyes, and I'm sure yours also, that female impersonation is an art form. It is an art form that we as the gay community can be proud of forever. Thank you.
Finalist number 8, Sable Chanel. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Emcee. We're going to take about a 10-minute intermission. We'll be back with our evening gown competition.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, judges, without further ado, we're going to move along to our evening gown competition. Someone get her money before they pass out. She'll get it, don't worry. Thank you.
with thousands of silver bugle beads. This unique off-the-shoulder trim consists of rhinestones carefully mounted atop rows of miniature white pearls. And as if this wasn't enough, this creation ends in a 2-foot-long beaded string. Ladies and gentlemen, Tracy Mills designed on paper, and now Gloria Klein models it for you. What else can be said but simply gorgeous? Finalist number two, Gloria Klein.
Royal Princess.
crested with purple sequins, crystal stones, and beads. The dolman sleeves fall to the hip and are fitted to the knee with a bias fishtail hip. Accessories are crystal, topaz, and purple stone earrings, designed especially for the gown by none other than the Dragon Lady Earring Company. Charles Jardin's evening comments take the last step in completing the look. A little Stephen Murray, a little Lauren Brock, royalty in purple. Finalist number six, Lauren Brock. Bianca Paige. Elegance, sophistication, and glamour are three words that come to mind when describing Bianca's stunning appearance in this Riazi evening gown. A cascade of black bugle beads sets the focal point for the dramatic effect of gold beads, sequins, and pearls about the top and sleeves. Matching earrings and pumps finish this look of class for which Bianca is known. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, finalist number seven, Bianca Paige.
New York, Morgan. This evening, pasta for that to have a move. Margaret leaves you with her signature perfume, Red from Giorgio of Beverly Hills. Ladies and gentlemen, finalist number 10 from New York, Margaret. I can't hear you out there, but I'm on. I don't want to beg you. There they go. Oh, you gotta start speaking Bubba knees, and it goes, finalist number 11 from Missouri, Kathy Kline. And Patti come together to bring you the ultimate in evening wear. As evening stars begin to shine in the midnight sky, Patti Klein shines without the twinkle of bugle beads or sequins. This stunning form fit, feminine creation of sheer black chiffon and black velvet, proves that the true elegance and grace can be only best by fashion that speaks for itself. It has timeless beauty and reigns supreme. Dazzling jet and limestone crystal accents are all that is needed to enhance this spectacular ensemble. Black satin evening tops complement this perfect picture of evening wear. Ladies and gentlemen judges, the only real star against the midnight sky is none other than finalist number 11, Kathy Klein. Thank you. Now I can do it. Finalist number 12 from Florida, Patti Cage. All that glitters is not just gold, yet glass, silver, and copper inlaid seductively upon illusion material fitted to the perfect model. Finalist number 12, Patti Cage. The dress was hand-beaded in China and features a petal-shaped train that snakes seductively wherever Patti walks. Topaz and jewels designed especially for Patti by Dragon Lady of Dallas, Texas. The elegant look of the cosmopolitan lady is finalist number 12, Patti Cage.
Just a touch of the pure innocence. Hanging
jet beam and glow bottles swing and glint from the edge of the sweetheart top. Earrings of heart stones complement this look, as do the plain black evening top. The gown is from Reality Night. This is Couture's new dazzle, as presented to you by Mahogany. This is the ultimate look for evening gown for 1990. Ladies and gentlemen, the look that is finalist number 14, Mahogany.
Yeah. just wrapping our race in evening gown. Well, we got nothing else to do, you know? We've done the talent, we've done the on-stage interview, and I know everyone has their favorite, but out of all 80 contestants, a record-breaking pageant this year in female impersonation history, never have been 80 contestants. And we think we have about 750 to 800 people tonight. Let's hear it for you for coming and supporting the pageant tonight. Wow, yay, thank you. Thank you. It's hot up here, I'm having a fan. I feel like I'm back in church. We want to thank all of you people for supporting the band and the connection. Everyone there, thank you. You've made it a fabulous week, Louisville. Next year for everyone in Louisville. Thank you for making us feel all the way from home.
From Florida, from Georgia.